The talk of theme of the talk is words, and the words actually separate us from all rest of the animals. So if we check, 200,000 years ago, that was when Homo sapiens evolved from monkeys, and the reason we are not one of the strongest species, we are one of the weakest actually, to be honest, but still we are the most dominant species on the earth, moving, looking towards going to a different planet. And this entire progress happened because of one thing, and that one thing is the communication. Around 70,000 years ago, a spoken communication evolved. So the communication before that was not very depth. It was like, you know, food, hungry, something like this. But when the communication evolved to complexities, for example, tomorrow at 4 a.m., tiger will come there, and if we go there together, we can hunt it. So when the communication evolved to such a complexity, the messages we could pass on evolved to even more complicated stuff, and that is the reason we are the most dominant species. Communication. Communication because of which we can combine our power and collaborate. And when that communication becomes a written language, a spoken language is easy, but when that becomes a written language, now that communication can happen to everywhere. So this was the start of progress of us as a species, and we have reached extremely large distance. So this is the words, and whenever we talk about written words, this is what is available to us. If I read a book by Elon Musk, he is available to me on call 24/7 any time I want him to. Book by Elon Musk, Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, Einstein, Richard Feynman, Newton, anybody which I like, anybody which I aspire to, their books are available to me 24/7 for me to learn and change my life. So this book though, I mean, there are lots of books available, but not many people change their lives with the book. And the reason is very simple. I mean, if anybody is going to therapy, in therapy, not always therapy works, not always people overcome their issues. The reason is not everyone wants to. A book can change our life only if we let it. And the reason I'm talking about this book is, like, you know, how we approach reading has changed my life. I want to share the approach. So this is my Thor t-shirt, which I'm wearing. Thor Ragnarok, which is one of my favorite movies in this Marvel series. And I like the executioner. So, you know, when he talks about behold my stuff, right? He's so materialistic that he goes, you know, using his transportation machine, which he has, he goes to different places and gets the different stuff. So similarly, behold my stuff. So this is my library, which I've compiled over, I would say, past 1 year only. And I have more, around 20 more books, which I've added to the stack. Currently more than 110, 120 live books or something. This is just my 1 year library. I mean, until now, I must have read more than 500 books. And some of the books I have read more than 10, 20 times at least. So that's my reading. But the point here is this number of books, which was like 17 books in 2019, 20 books in 2016, that alone is not enough if we do it wrong. So the point is, I mean, everybody knows, right? We are all told to read a book. We can't get the results we want by doing the wrong thing. We have to change our actions so that we can get what we want. But what is never get told is, like, if we do the right thing in a wrong way, that still doesn't give us a result. Everybody is reading books, but if I'm reading them in a wrong way, it doesn't lead to any results. So this is what we need to get sorted in our mind, and we need to learn to read the books in an efficient way. You know, just the number of books, you know, adding, not a right way. The right way, when we do the right thing in the right way, that's when the true growth is there. Okay. So the true growth, which I observed in my life, was through this single 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. I've read it more than 15 times at least, and I've read books on one of the habits in all of that book, and it's an amazing book. So let's go about the theme of the session. Okay, so we are going through three sections: why to read a book, how to read a book, and what to read. So why to read a book is very simple. I mean, if we talk about why to read a book, we all know there are two ways of reading a book. For example, there are few people here which can resonate with this. I read a book because I love it. Whether it is science fiction or science or comics or novels or murder mystery or thriller or anything it may be, I read books because I love them. And because I love them, I can read even complex books and I can get a lot of value out of it. But if you don't love them now, it's good to know that, you know, it's the problem is romantic movies, right? They make us think that there is a soulmate and there is a passion. And if you don't love somebody, you will never ever love them in your life. No. You can develop love if you have liking. And if you can also develop liking, if you start that way, you have to start small. If you read books which you have fun reading, that's it. You can slowly grow your love of reading. So one way of reading the book is like, if you don't love them, you can develop the love. And the second way is we can simply, you know, just think like this. We read for rewards. Books help. That's it. As long as this thing is clear, it's as good as bribe. We are reading not because we like it. We are reading them because we have to. Okay. That's the one reason. And what happens is this. Whatever we do leads to whatever results we get. So our actions lead to our results. Now, if we want to change our results, we want to change our actions. And if you want to change our actions, that only is possible through the new information we can learn from the books. Simple. Books open our mind, and from that new insight which we have, we will simply act differently and we'll get different results. Plain and simple. We are reading the books for reward the book offers us. Simple. So now, this is the why part. And now, the most important part, the how. How of reading the book, the most important session, I would say, part of the topic. Okay. So in the how part, what we have is like, this is one amazing story. So Agias something, I mean, he was a zoologist, extremely popular, very scientifically thorough zoologist. And this story is, you know, if you search, look at your fish. This is the story. He had a student he was mentoring, and the assignment he had given his student is, this is a fish, a stuffed fish, which was, you know, in a chemical, it was preserved, and he was asked to draw that fish. That's it. Look at the fish, look at your fish and draw it. That was the assignment. He gave him time and he came back after 15 minutes and say, show me what you do. You know, after checking the drawing and observing and something, I was like, it's not enough. Take more time, observe it more deeply and draw what you see. He came back after 2 hours and saw, show me what you have drawn. He was still not happy with what was drawn. Then he said, okay, you still haven't seen enough. Look at your fish deeply and draw it. I'll come back next day. So now the next day's night, that's when he came back. And until that time, the student who was trying to get mentored by that zoologist, he was looking at the fish very deeply, trying to discover more things he missed in the first time, and he was drawing it. He came back after a day. He was still not happy. You still haven't looked at it enough. I'll come back after a week. Still after a week, he was not happy. He came back after a month. Then he came back after 2 months. This went on for 8 months. And after 8 months, the student realized how much there is to see. Even a small object like fish. Knowing the patterns, knowing the color combination, knowing how it must have evolved. The complexity of life in a single image. He realized there is so much to see if you go deeper and deeper and deeper. And that is what we miss all the time. Even right now, we ignore so much. The bandwidth of our visual is like, everybody knows, we have HD retina display on iPad. It means, what's the bandwidth? It's like around 1 MB per second is the bandwidth of our iPad. It's retina display. It means 1 MB per second is our eye's bandwidth. Our eye sees at 1 MB per second, that's the information. And we ignore almost all of it. There is so much to see, we just don't look closer. And that's the theme of how to read the book. You just have to go deeper and deeper and notice more. So this is the central theme. Reading a multiple books is useless. It doesn't add any value. You learn more by reading a single book again and again and again and again, rather than reading multiple books single time. Solely, 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, I was reading it straight for at least 3-4 months. Straight. Same book again and again and again and again. And that's when I realized how much I had missed. I'd read that book long time back, multiple times. But I learned more when I was reading it in depth. So reading it depth looked like this. So for example, these are few of the big books which I applied this process to. 7 Habits of Highly Effective People around 15 times. Sapiens book, I read around 5-6 times at least. Then Harry Potter, this is a fan fiction, not the official Harry Potter. This book I read even more than 5-6 times. So in this, I noticed a lot of stuff. For example, stuff I noticed in 7 Habits. All 7 Habits, as the word says, right? I understood them more and more in each iteration. I thought I had understood them. It turns out I hadn't. So this is how you read a book. You read a book by going through them again and again and again. But there is a framework to this framework, which I actually got from reading it multiple times. And the framework is the 7-point framework from, you know, 7 Horcruxes in Harry Potter. This is the 7-point framework I'm going to talk about, the crux of the talk. Okay. Point number one, intention. If you are reading the book just for the information, not gonna add value to you. What happens is, like, just information is not enough. If you are not reading a book to change your action or change your thinking, it's not gonna lead to any permanent change at all. What happens? You read a book, you have the book, the information temporary available in your brain. You read next book, that temporary information get replaced with the new information, and that's it. It gets wiped out. The old information gets wiped out. So you have to read a book with intention to change, and you move on only after you have changed. That's it. Intention to change, and now one book is more than enough, because if one book leads to a permanent change, that is more than enough. I mean, not many people actually do that. You know, most people live their life without changing ever. So, and achieving change is one of the most difficult things. So intention is the first thing we have to have while reading any book. The second point is relate. So the book was written by the author by relating it to his own life. He talks about his own wife, family, his situation, his upbringing, his thought process, his emotions. And actually that is his author's book. When we are reading the author's book, unless we relate that book to our own life, in reading the 7 Habits, unless I think about when I was taking ownership and when I was not, when one of my friends were taking their ownership and they were not, unless I do all of this, it's not useful at all. So the book is author's, and while we are reading it, we have to relate that to our life. Then it becomes our book. Read with intention to change, relate that book to your own life, and only then you can actually go to a step next level, which is reflection. If you read something, you have to reflect on it. Is it really true? Does it match with my experiences? Should I do it this way, or do I don't need to do it? Are there any other ways to do this way? So unless we reflect, the book is useless. And there is a really good analogy I like to relate. I mean, reading without reflection is like eating without digestion. Both leads to shit. Reflection is very important. Without that, there is no use of either any book, any even a talk like this. You have to reflect on it. You have to go back on it again and again and again. And the reflection leads to value. So reflection is very important, and it's like, you know, without it, book is useless. It's as if we have not even read the book. Okay. The fourth point is priority. If I'm reading a 7 Habits book or any other book, 7 Habits has 7 points. You know, any other book might have 10, 20, 30 points or something. Unless we prioritize which one should be learnt first. It's not the first chapter, right? If I read something on first page, I see, okay, this is what you should do. You won't directly jump in to change that about yourself. You have to prioritize which one will make the most impact to your life. Unless we sort that in descending order of impact, and we decide, okay, this thing will make the most impact to my life, and it requires decent amount of efforts. Not too much. I mean, if I can choose somebody, something which has too little efforts and lots of impact, that's the best thing to change. Prioritize is must. Identifying what to change. I mean, we are reading with intention to change, right? We have to choose what to change. That's the point number five, four. We have to prioritize. And then point number five is very important, which is action plan. So action plan is, this is like a military kind of theme, ready, aim and fire. It's never ready, fire and aim. If we simply go blindly, I mean, that's what blind means, right? We are going in blind. It might not even lead to result which we want. We have to plan. So what to change, how to change it, how much time it might take it. All of these things we have to plan. And then we go to the most important stage, which is action. I mean, The reason I don't have six packs is not that I don't know how to exercise. Everybody knows what to do, how to do it. But the point is, I don't do it. Everybody knows how to improve their grades. Everybody knows how to earn more money. Everybody knows how to kind of like change their life, to how to be a better, let's say, friend or something, whatever you want to do. The most difficult part is the secret in last time was the knowledge. Now it's not the knowledge, it's action. There are so many few people who take action. The workout routine of everybody is available. The study routine of everybody is available. What they read, what they did, everything is available. The action is rare. The sixth part is action. So we make an action plan and we keep taking action again and again and again and again. And that is very important. Then in that action is like when we take new action, it leads to new result. It leads to more confidence. We take more action, the same action again and again and again. And we change our life. We change our results. And this thing, so right thing to do in the right way gives the right results. And the most amazing part which I feel of the books is this. Everybody who does this gets the result. There is nobody, let's say, who exercises when his muscles are suddenly going to say, okay, I don't want to grow for you. If you follow it, you'll get the result. And that's the best part. Everybody can get it. And this is what I love about it. The success is inevitable for those who pay the price. Thanos was a great villain because he's willing to pay the price for his conviction and whatever needed to be done, he was willing to do it and he did it. The action. So doing that is the amazing part because then result becomes just a question of time. What, however time it takes. So the subset of that action thing is this, wherein you have to keep on repeating your action until that becomes your second nature. Okay, so you see, this is, I love this quote by Bruce Lee, wherein he says, I'm afraid of a man who has practiced one kick 10,000 times than a man who has practiced 10,000 kicks once. Kind of like the same reading thing. When you repeat it so many times, it becomes your second nature. It takes around 2 months for your brain to start changing. I've personally experienced that. I was impatient. I'm not that impatient anymore. I was short-tempered. I was not that short-tempered anymore. I was easily stressed. I am not that easily stressed anymore. I did not have any self-awareness. Now I have quite a bit. So in trying to learn these things, I have practiced the things. I have practiced the action plan. I know it takes around 2 months of work for your brain to start changing. Do that for 2-3 times. Around 6-7 months, things change quite a bit. Do that for 2 years. It becomes your second nature. We feel like when we become something new, we are letting go of who we were, but that's not true. The new you can become your default nature, and that's the fun part. The growth becomes permanent. The person we become is who we will remain. That's the fun part. So the beginner is like somebody who knows what needs to be done. The capable is someone who spends time learning that, taking action. Takes around 6 months or maybe 1-2 years to be here. And second nature, do that for more time, 2 years, I think you become second nature. And after that, it's just question of continuing that. So in 7 habits, I'm at second nature for habit number 1. I'm at capable for habit number 5. Rest I've already forgotten. Now I'm going to restart. So the 7th habit was actually sharpen the saw, refresh. I forgot to do that. So I forgot habits 2, 3, 4. But others, yes, I have this thing already part of my day-to-day life. So the old thinking, coupled with reflection, leads with repetition, leads to new thinking, which leads to the results. That's it. And once we be patient and once we kind of like keep doing this, we'll get results. That's it. That's all it needs. So the 7th thing is finally adjustment. So what happens is like if we think like, okay, I wanna go somewhere. The action plan never works. You know, things go wrong. It's life. Murphy's Law. Shit happens. Always something or other comes up or a new TV show comes up and which you have to watch. So it's like, it's a very long path. We have to adjust our plan accordingly, but you have to keep acting. That's it. So you see, this is what we have to do. So the entire action plan is one angle. Read with intention to change, relate, reflect, prioritize, action plan, action, and final adjustment. 7-point plan. To read, learn from any book. You have to choose just one book. That's it. No more than that. So the final part is like, this is the kind of what part. So I talked about how to read. Now the final part is what to read. So what to read is kind of like this. I mean, if you take a screenshot or maybe alas Jatin to share this thing with everybody. So I have made list of few things which I think are essential for anybody in their life to learn. I mean, I did not have growth mindset, I did not have curiosity, I didn't substance character growing these things. So I think these 6-7 things are essential for anybody in no matter what area they are in. And if you follow the pattern to read these books, you'll get a lot of value in your life. And I think 2-3 years is more than enough to go through this. So this was the final part, what? And the thing which I want to conclude with, you know, is Inception. So I really loved this movie because it was all about planting an idea. The idea which is like the most resilient virus. An idea which can change your entire life. An idea which is fully formed, fully understood, which can change your life. Now, this idea, most important part is this idea has to be nurtured. And I mentioned what I think about how to read a book. Now, this has to be nurtured by you. And once you do that, that's when you can reap the harvest of the seed you have planted and nurtured yourself. So, all it takes is time, action, and the framework to be followed. And that's it. So I hope this Inception which I did was successful, and if you follow this thing, I think you will see really great results, and that's it from my side. Thank you.